Hi, AT from CNC at home. A couple videos back we made these nice Olympic rings. That turned out really well. One thing that I didn't do with this, and I thought about at the time and then either forgot or changed my mind, but I've changed it again, I don't know. I wanted to have something that indicated what Olympics this was. So I'm thinking on this middle ring, I'm going to put the year, so 2024, and then this is the 33rd Olympiad, so it'll, and they'd use Roman numerals, so it'll be XXXIII. So it'll be 2024, and then the Roman numerals and the word Olympiad. Now the trick is, I've taken this out of the laser. So how do I get that to work? We're going to use our good old friend, the print and cut feature. I'm going to identify a couple spots on my material and use print and cut to align my text so that it gets put on here exactly where I want it to be. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Let's head over to LightBurn and I'll show you first of all how I get the text to follow this arc, and then we'll use the print and cut to see how we get this aligned in the laser so that it prints where it's supposed to be. Let's head over to LightBurn. In LightBurn, the first thing we want to do is bring in our ring project. So I'll go ahead and open that. It was a recent project. There we have it. Let's zoom in on that so we can see what we're doing. Now the intent is to get the text to follow this arc. And that usually works out pretty well, but there is kind of an issue that we're going to run into. And we'll see if we can deal with that or figure that out. So let's first get our text on here. So we'll go ahead and just put text on there, and we're going to do 6 on the height because that's what fits in here nicely. And so we'll do 2024, maybe I'll put a dash in there, and then it's XXXIII Olympiad. All right, so that looks good, and we do want that filled in, so let's switch that to a different layer. Let's go ahead and let's put that on the blue layer and go into our library and get that set to plywood fill. We'll assign that. Okay, so that looks good. And it just needs to be in here. So what we should be able to do is click on this, shift select this arc, and I want it to sit on top of that. We go to our tools and apply to text. What it does is it goes in the middle. And that's not where we want that. We want that to be out a little further. We want to follow an arc that's kind of in the middle of this ring. So let's just do an undo on that real quick. What we're going to want to do is we're going to want to have a arc that goes through the middle. What I had hoped to do was to use the offset shape. Unfortunately, when I did that, the offset shape didn't work quite how I wanted it. Put all the text over here, and that's not what I want. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to draw a new arc and hold the shift key down so it's an actual circle. Let's go ahead and throw this on a construction or a tool layer. And now normally what I'd be able to do is to snap that to the center of an existing object. Unfortunately, it doesn't want to snap. Even though the center of this is right there, when I select my object and I get it really close, it's not snapping. I was just checking here to make sure I had my snap to object on, and I do. What we're going to have to do is manually locate this, and then we'll have to resize it to be what we need. So let's get some information from this arc. Come over to our measuring tool, and then we'll hover over the arc here. And we can see that the arc radius is 39.84, and the center of that is at 150 by 138.59. So let's just write that down. So with those two pieces of information, we should be able to get our arc into the correct spot. So let's go ahead and select this arc, and then we will get its X position. We'll just key in 150, and then its Y position is 138.59. Well, that's not right. I wrote down the wrong number. Let's look at this again. We want the center, not to the start point. Okay, so the center is 98.75. Let's use that value. Let's key that in here. 98.75. That looks much better. And the radius of this arc was 39.84. So let's change the width of ours. We'll key in the 39.84. And then we'll add on, or we'll multiply that by 2, because that's going to be the width. We'll resize from the center. Okay, now we have an arc that's right in the middle how we want that. So we know the radius of the first one is 39.84. Let's measure the radius of this one. The radius of that is 46.87. So we want the size of our arc to be right in between those two. So we're going to get the calculator out and do a little math. So we have 46.87 minus 39.84 gives us 7.03. Okay, so let's go in. We've got our arc, and we're going to add on to that 7.03. And that gets us right in the middle. So that's exactly what we want to do. Here's one more issue that we're going to run into, and I'll show you how we can solve that quickly. So we grab our text. I do a shift select, grab the arc, come over to tools, apply it a path, and it's over here on the side, which isn't where we want that. So what we want to do is rotate this 90 degrees, which didn't quite do what we wanted because it didn't rotate around the center of our arc. It rotated around the center of the text. So what we need to do is take our circle that we're going to follow, this path, and we'll rotate that 90 degrees. Visually, we don't see anything change. We'll select the text, shift select our arc, then we will apply the text again, and it's right where we want it to be. So we'll come over here to our layers. We're not going to need to cut out the black or the red, because that's already been done. All we want is the blue. So this is the part that we want. What we will need to do for our print and cut is we'll need to add a couple reference marks. So let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to do a circle, press shift so I can actually get a circle. I'm going to say 10 on that. I will duplicate it because we need 2. And we have 2 circles. I'm going to put one down on this spot, and I'm going to put one over here on this spot, because those are about as far apart as we can get on this project. So I'll bring this down, and that does snap where we want it. And I'll bring this one over and snap it right there. Now that I have these 2 reference marks on my material, or on my CAD drawing essentially, let's get that aligned up over on the laser. I'm going to move the laser to this point, and then I'll use the print and cut to identify as the first spot. Then I will move the laser to this point and identify this as my second spot. The way the print and cut works is when we select an object, it uses the center of that object. So that's why I use circles, and I get them centered up on a spot that I can identify my part. So let's go over and take a look at our material and get our laser lined up. Thank you. I have the laser on this spot. I've got my registration mark identified. So under laser, we go print and cut, and we'll set our first position. Now let's move the laser over to this spot. Now the laser is in this second position, and I can identify that under print and cut. Second spot. Then under print and cut, I'm going to align my output to target. For this to work properly, we do have to be in absolute coordinates, otherwise print and cut won't work. This should be all set to go. Let's make sure that our layers are not set for output on both the red and the black layer. Our tool layer doesn't matter because that never prints, and all we have is our blue layer, which is our text. We can do a quick preview. That's funny that it looks a little sideways in the preview, but that makes sense because our material is a little sideways. Let's go ahead and burn this. Let's take a look at the laser and watch that. I hope you thought that was easy. I thought that was relatively easy, and the results were fantastic. It follows the arc perfectly. It's right in the middle, and I just set this on my laser bed. And I let print and cut figure out exactly where it was and how to do that. Just another way that print and cut is a very powerful and easy tool to use. Something to keep in mind. I hope you enjoyed this video on the LightBurn Print and Cut feature. If you like the content of our channel, think about subscribing. Oh yeah, like, that's what the thumbs up are for. Like the video. Enjoy doing your CNC at home projects. And maybe play around with print and cut. Yeah.
Oops.